we were trying to find the units in Gaussian integers. We started with a1 plus b1i, and we wanted to check if there are elements a2 plus b2i whose product will give us 1, and we realize that we need a2 upon a1 equal to minus b2 upon b1 to be equal. We called it k, and the multiplication immediately gave us that k into a1 square plus b1 square is equal to 1. See, this problem and many later problems actually use some basic elementary number theory. So, they all have somewhat a similar flavor, and you need to look at the integers a little carefully. Now, a1 and b1 are integers, and what do I get? K is not an integer. K does not have to be an integer, and k is equal to 1 over a1 square plus b1 square. But what does that mean? Then I get a2 as a1 upon a1 square plus b1 square, and b2 as b2 upon a1 square plus b1 square. Look at that. And surely a2 and b2 need to be integers. K need not be integers, but surely a2 and b2 are. And look at the magnitudes, the numerator, these are all integers, and certainly in magnitude the numerator is smaller than the denominator, unless we have got some special case. Now, a2 and b2 will be integers only if, see, if a1 and b1 both are non-zero, then this is going to be bigger than a1, and this is also going to be bigger than b1. So, this will not be an integer. So, this a1, a2 and b2 will be inside only if a1 is equal to 0 or b1 equal to 0. Thus, the units in zx are plus or minus 1 and plus or minus I only. If a1 is equal to 0, a2 is equal to 0, and b2 will be an integer only if b1 is plus or minus 1. Similarly, if b1 is equal to 0, again you get the answer a1 equal to plus or minus 1. Accordingly, the only units in I, this is not the ring of polynomials, but this is the ring of Gaussian numbers, and we have got the solution. We will now look at the next problem and try to solve those. Let us see number 32. Let n be an integer bigger than n. N in n, n bigger than 1. And we have x square equal to x for all x in the ring R. And what are we supposed to prove? We have to prove that if for a, b in R, a, b is equal to 0, then b, a is also equal to 0. This is what we have to prove. But we are given a special relation, that is x square equal to x for every x in R. So, x raised to n, I am sorry. N is a positive integer bigger than 1 such that x raised to n is equal to x, and this happens for every x in R. Now, if there is a pair AB with AB equal to 0, we have to show that BA equal to 0. Simple. You apply the rule to AB, to BA, not AB, but to BA. So, what is x raised to n? X raised to n is BA, BA, BA n times. No problem. We use the simple associative law and join them together. Keep one B here, then make it AB, 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 and finally A again. And we know that AB is equal to 0. So, this is equal to B 0 A, and that is going to be equal to 0. Because this is equal to x raised to n is equal to x, and that is B A. Okay. So, many of these problems are quite simple and you will get them very quickly provided you use the laws rather cleverly. So, this was 32, let us look at 33. 33 is rather easy and I want to leave it to you, although the formulation of conjecture is not easy. So, let us do that then. Okay. Let us make at least the part of it we will prove and then leave the rest to you. For P equal to 3, 7 and 11 in ZP, we want the solutions of A square plus B square equal to 0. So, what is this ZP? ZP is the residue classes modulo P. P is n odd prime. And what are the values for P? P is equal to 3, 7 or 11. Can we find solutions for this? Let us look at it. Let us look at 7 for example. What is Z7? These are the residue classes up to 6 bar. And what are their squares? Look at the squares now. The squares of all those x bar squares, x bar in Z7, these are 0, 1, 2 2's are 4, so that is 4, 3 3's are 9, that comes out to 2 again, 4 4's are 16, that is also 2. 5 5s are 25, 25 is 4 and 6 bar is, square is 1 bar. So, these are all the squares. Now, can you find 2 squares which add up to 0? That is 2 squares which add up to number divisible by 7. So, there is no solution. See, the only squares are 1, 2, 4 and 0. No 2 will add up to 7 or multiple of 7. No solution of A square plus B square equal to 0. You can check that for P equal to 3 and P equal to 11 also there is no solution.